What is up, my frosty brethren? My name is Arctic. Today is Thursday. That means we got some Gears of War discussion going on. Ultimate Edition came out on Tuesday, 2 days ago. A lot of folks were playing beforehand. We had the show matches on Friday. We had some pretty good matches. Very interesting to see how people were kind of embracing the idea of a competitive Gears of War. Also had an announcement, I think this about the same day as, I don't know, it was the past 5 days. I don't know what day it was exactly, but ESL will be picking up Gears of War Ultimate Edition as a competitive title. I don't know if that means they're going to be streaming matches or just holding tournaments or whatever, but it's a nice step forward. It has, I think, a lot more folks that are in the competitive scene a little bit more excited about the comeback, the Gears comeback, so to speak. So what I wanted to do with this video is just give you guys some more impressions of Gears of War Ultimate Edition. I talked about the beta, had some impressions there, and I gave like a very first initial impressions on Frag Logic on Tuesday. If you guys care to check that out, you can as well. But you know, I had some more time. We streamed now 3 mornings in a row. This morning we actually had Callie North join us, so we had me, Orange, which is my brother, and Callie North all playing, which was very fun. Very first, I want to say that we are not competing on Gears of War Ultimate Edition. I will be casting Hypefest Station October 2nd through the 4th, which I've mentioned multiple times throughout the last basically couple years, is that I've been interested in casting again, and that's what I'll be focused on in terms of Gears of War competitively. Not competing, not interested in doing that at all. So we got that out the way. But from this game, you know, there's some things that I feel like are in line with my expectations for Gears. I know that there's a lot of strong feelings about a lot of different things in the game right now, which I expected from the Gears of War community. This is nothing new, not surprising at all to have people love it, hate it, hate things about certain things, love things about other aspects of the game. But for the most part, this is a Gears of War 1 remake, and they are pretty true in that. And there were some problems with Gears of War 1 that are obviously bringing you know, their ugly heads up again, and people are upset. Either they came in at Gears 3 and those things were polished and fixed, or they came in on Gears 1 expecting Ultimate Edition not to have those things. I'm pointing at the melee two-piece shotgun as the prime example. And so they're upset at that. Shotgun consistency isn't, I think, where a lot of people want it to be. To be honest with you, the first day I was not feeling it, and subsequently the next 2 days, yesterday and today that I played, I felt much more consistent with my shotgun. And for a lot of people, I think coming from Gears 3, it does not shoot from the barrel. It shoots from the center screen. And then when you're right up on someone, it shoots from the barrel. According to, I have not tested this, according to what I've read around people that are testing these things. So it has the same shooting mechanics as Gears of War Judgment. That may have people upset or not. In my opinion, it made things a little bit better because you didn't get the backpack, which was a big issue in Gears of War 1. I can't remember if it was fixed in Gears 2, but that's basically when someone is through your body behind you on your screen and you shoot the shotgun and it chunks them and explodes their body, and you're both saying, "What the hell was that?" pretty much, both the person that died and the person that got the shot off, because it just looked weird from an animation standpoint. So I believe Gears Judgment's shotgun center screen and from the barrel, the dual aspect of it was supposed to remedy that, and I have not had any backpacks so far. Speaking to, you know, again, the two-piece, you know, it was a part of Gears of War 1. I expected it to be a possibility in this game, and sure enough, it is. And, you know, we're starting off early, but I promise you, I have not run into a whole lot of people trying to two-piece, although I will say that we had one guy, I think it was Rizzo TB, who was trying to melee quite a bit. You know, there's like one or two players every time that are pretty heavy on melee, but, you know, it's not to the point where it was by the end of Gears of War 1, where you knew someone was going to, melee you and get that two piece. But I promise you, it will accelerate very quickly and get to that point. I wouldn't be surprised if a week from now, it is, running rampant in multiplayer with folks trying to basically run at you and two piece you nonstop. So, be prepared for that. It is annoying. That is one of the things that I did not like about Gears of War 1. and it's back. So again, it's in line with my expectations for the game, so I can't say I'm super surprised or anything. But that is an aspect of the game that I did not enjoy. Other than that, I mean, movement-wise, it feels better bouncing off of walls. You get less sticky situations. I did run into a glitch, which I'll have to highlight and go through my stream and find it. Previously, when you would melee, or I'm sorry, when you would take cover on the same point where your teammate was and came off, you would get stuck in this weird glitch where your body would pop up and you had no ability to do any moves. You had to actually hit your melee or rev your chainsaw in order for you to come out of that. So I had not experienced that since it might have been even a thing on Gears 3, but I knew it was an issue. It's a very edge case scenario. Some of you guys might know what I'm talking about. If I actually find it, I'll clip it and I'll talk specifically to it and how to do it, and hopefully the Coalition can try to repro it and fix that issue, because it was one that I did not like, and can be an issue if you are playing a competitive team and a lot of folks take the same points of contact on cover and stuff. So you kind of get the same type of actions, and so it'll happen more frequently. Let me see, shotgun sound still sounds awful, and I brought this up several times. I did it during the beta, and I said, hey, the shotgun sound sounds really off. And I had people that were that hadn't had a chance to play or that were in the beta also going tooth and nail trying to defend it, saying, oh, it's the alpha sounds. Don't worry, it'll be fixed. What are you talking about? These are the alpha sounds. And the sound of the shotgun still sounds the same, which doesn't sound very good. I would say out of all the sounds, it's one that really is throwing me off, because it doesn't just, I don't know, it doesn't have enough weight to it. There's just something about the shotgun sound that sounds off. And I've heard numerous people say it. I mentioned it during the beta, and so I was under the impression that it would be remedied because they said they were improving sounds, but obviously that is not something that was fixed or felt like it needed to be a little bit better. So shotgun sound doesn't sound very good. Shotgun in general, consistency, again, for me, hasn't been an issue. Lancer feels good. For those that you know how to get your actives, know how to get angles, know where to be aiming. I know there's probably a lot of folks that feel like the Lancer is weak, but if you guys have been watching gameplay, man, we've been downing the heck out of people. You know, Gears of War 1 was always more about the team shot, and I think folks that might be coming from Gears 3 with those unbelievably strong rifles could have different expectations. And, you know, the pace of Gears of War 1, I think, is a little faster in that because you can't, or you have to rely more on team shot, people can push you and get in your face a lot faster. So, you know, some of those people coming from that game could have a difficult time adjusting to it. Outside of that, pistol, I think I mentioned in the beta, pistol felt a little inconsistent or was firing slow. Whatever they did, if they made no changes, then it was just me. If they did make changes, the pistol feels better to me. And really, outside of that, boomshot doesn't seem like it's broken now. The explosion seems bigger. They're more consistent on the downs. No one's chunking boomshot and not taking damage when they're on cover. Torque bow, man, oh man. I was not a big torque bow player. But let me tell you guys, the torque bow feels awesome. If you are hot with it, man, you can get a lot of consecutive sticks. And sniping has always been something that I've done in Gears, and it feels pretty much on par. Outside of that, you know, you got maps. Maps aren't, not all of them. I didn't like all of the Gears of War 1 maps. There's actually very few that I think are really good. War Machine, love playing that map. Gridlock is, I'm pretty neutral on because there's not a lot of options. Clock Tower, I think, is really good. And then outside of that, everything is like average or below average. Played Garden, and I didn't want to play Garden. Played it on Blitz, and not happy about that at all. Not happy about that map at all. But, you know, it is what it is. It's again, it's in line with my expectations. There's maps that I don't like. There's maps that I enjoy playing. So, you know, I'm happy to be playing some Gears again. Got more content for you guys on the channel. Mixing it up with now Gears and Destiny. Then we'll get some Halo in here, as well as some new games for the fall. Battlefront, looking at you. But all in all, you know, I think Ultimate Edition is about in line. It's not higher than my expectations. It's not lower than my expectations. It's right in line with what I expected for a remake. And, you know, I can't say I'm disappointed. Can't say that they fail. Can't say that it's really good. It's just okay. So those are my thoughts on it. If you guys have any other questions, please let me know down in the description. And until the next time, folks, I will catch you all later. Stay frosty. If you like this video, you should probably click on the one down below. That'll take you to another video. You may like it. A little bit about me. I'm a former pro player. I play PC and console, mostly shooters. I also have a gaming podcast. I do tips and tactics, live gameplays. Check out my Twitch. Also, I work in the industry. Why are you not subscribed?